Dr. Chris Croner here. Time for a story about personality. In terms of psychology, it really pays to know the personalities of the people you're selling to, because it can give you a huge edge over competitors who sell well clinically, but miss the opportunity to connect emotionally. Here's a personal selling story from one of my friends. He was with a large commercial real estate firm, and they were pitching the property management and leasing of a prestige office building in Chicago. 60 stories, premium location, a real beauty. The trouble was that the new owners were headquartered in New York and were not familiar with the nuances of the Chicago market. So they invited everybody to pitch the business. A proverbial all-day beauty contest with one firm coming in after another. Plus, several of the firms were well known nationally, and my friend's firm was local. So the odds of their winning the deal weren't great. So my friend needed to figure out an edge, and he found it when he called around and asked about the guys who were flying in for pitch day. First of all, although they were representing a large Japanese bank, these guys were Americans, and they were from New York. And New York often meant no nonsense and a very low tolerance for BS. My friend also made arrangements to be the last team to pitch, which, by the way, you should always do. And he lined up a team of tougher people, able to stand up to the New York way of communicating. Then, since my friend figured his chances were low anyway, he decided to put in the kicker. When it came time to meet, the setup was exactly the way he thought it would be. He bumped into a competitor on the way out who looked like they had been put through the ringer. When my friend's team went into the room, it was smelly and disheveled with food and drinks all over the place, and the prospects were exhausted and burned out. So, here's how he started the meeting. "Guys, you've had a long day, and I'm sure the last thing you want to do is hear another dog and pony show about another real estate firm. Tell you what," he reached into a brown bag he brought and pulled out 2 6-packs of Heinekens. He said, "I know it's 6 o'clock in New York. Why don't we just pop a few beers? We'll throw out our PowerPoint presentation, and let's just kick around about how we are gonna lease the crap out of your beautiful new building." Except he didn't say crap. He used a synonym that starts with S. So there was a long pause. My friend wasn't sure he wouldn't just get dismissed, and the younger guys were looking at their leader for guidance. Their leader nodded and said, "Did you bring an opener?" My friend reached into his jacket pocket and pulled one out and gave it to him. He popped open a beer and game on. They won the assignment and were forever referred to as the Heineken guys. Obviously, when I heard this story, I knew I had to share it with you. Certainly, knowing your audience allows you a huge opportunity to distinguish yourself on an emotional level. I also like the way my friend sized up his odds and determined he had to take a higher risk to land the account. Not playing defense and actually leveraging fear to higher performance, in this case, through enhanced creativity, is a trait shared by the highest performance athletes and salespeople. For those of you hunter salespeople watching, study your quarry and customize your tactics to fit the hunt. See you next time. Thank you for joining me today. If you like this video, please make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click the subscribe button below this video to stay up to date on the latest in sales psychology. See you next time.